Hi, AT from CNC at home. I have a new method, at least new for me, of etching glass, and that's to use tempera paint. Growing up, we always call it tempera paint, but it's, I'm not sure exactly how it's pronounced, but it's tempera? I don't know. There's an A at the end. We always call it tempera paint. Anyway, it's a powder. You mix it with water. I used just this little plastic bowl and mixed it 50-50. So that's 50% tempera paint. It's a powder, and then 50% water. And I just used this styrofoam brush to apply it. The process is basically taking the brush, and as an example, you would just paint it on to your glass. Let it dry, paint on another layer, let it dry, paint on another layer. I found that four layers was plenty, and maybe two or three layers would work. I did four. I think one of the tests I did more than four layers, and that also worked just fine. Just the getting a nice even coat is what you want to do. What this allows you to do is take a diode laser that uses the blue light, which is the kind we have, and it allows you to etch glass. Otherwise, the laser is just going to go right through it and do nothing. What we've done in the past is we've used black spray paint. We've sprayed that on either the surface we're going to etch, or we'll cut through the glass, depending on whichever method you want to use. But it cuts on the surface where the black paint is. I've also done a method where I've put the glass onto a black surface and done the etching. They both worked fairly well. The problem with both of those, especially the spray painting, is the cleanup. You can't just rinse that off with water. You have to use some more aggressive chemicals, a lacquer thinner, acetone, or paint thinner of any kind to get that cleaned off. With the tempera paint, it's water soluble. So once you've done the burn, you just put that under running water, rinses right off. Couldn't be easier for the cleanup. Well, I suppose it could be easier. The cleanup is very easy with the tempera paint. And once you're done, there's no residue left over. I want to do a couple quick sample burns with this, see how they turn out. I picked up a couple glass mugs at the dollar store, so the investment was pretty minimal. And the tempera paint I just picked up, and I'll put a link down below if you want to get the same stuff I did. It seemed to work. Anyway, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Let's go see how the burning worked on this. I have put my first coat of the tempera paint onto this mug. I will put several coats to get a nice, even, thick coating so that I'll be able to etch with the laser onto the glass mug. Here we can see that the first etching worked very well. This was using the tempera paint and then just lasering this. Worked out well. This is an image. The next one I'm going to do on the back side is going to be burning a vector. So when I get more layers on here, that's what I'll be doing. I have four coats of the tempera paint on my glass. I'm going to get this into the laser, lined up, and start the burn. Here's the first burn. It turned out really well. And this last one also turned out well. This process seems to be pretty good. The nice thing about the tempera paint is it washes off with water. It's pretty much non-toxic. Just paint on. This one was four layers. It goes on thin, just nice four even coats. Put it in the laser and burned it, and it turned out really well. This will be a good process to be using going forward. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. If you like the content of our videos,
think about subscribing. Enjoy doing your CNC at home projects.
Oops.